Alrighty, well, if you've seen my How I Do Barrows guide, then this video is going to be very much similar to that. It's going to be literally, I'm going to show you how I did my clue scrolls, and I'm going to explain why I use every item, and then I'll go over, like, I think it's all of the medium clue steps, but it might not be all of them, and like what items relate to it, and what you can use if you don't have the item, or maybe there's a better item. So let's get right into it. First of all, the bank end. So as you can see in the, oh wait, I'm opening implements right now. So you open your implements and boom, we got clue scroll right there. So you see, I pick up the clue scroll, then I'm withdrawing these things in a particular order so that they're in a particular place in my inventory, so they're easy to click. Now right there in the bank, you can see I have two stacks of silver necklaces. Now the one that where there's just one on its own, that's one that has less than five charges, and the rest have five charges. Once you use any item with charges, it will keep using the same placeholder over and over again. So no matter if it's four charges, three charges, two charges, or one charge, this makes it a lot easier to withdraw the correct necklace and not be using five charge necklaces all the time, you know what I mean? Before we jump into the inventory, I'll definitely recommend like doing all of the hidey holes before you start doing clues, else you'll have to bring a hammer, saw, nails, and planks with you to build the hidey holes as you go. And there's a link in the description to all the hidey hole locations and the items needed for them, courtesy of the 07 wiki. I literally just bought all the items, went out of planks, saw, hammer, and nails, and just made all of them and filled all of them before I even started doing medium clues. So I'd definitely recommend doing that. So let's review the inventory. So first of all, obviously the clue scroll. You need to be clicking on this, every time you do a clue. So obviously that's at the top left of your inventory, so you can click it nice and easy. Second is a stamina potion, because if you've got a long clue and you need to run a lot of places, you're going to need it. Now the crafting cape, that is used for one clue, and I'll put that on screen now, and it's also used just to bank in general, but obviously you can replace that with a Castle Wars ring. Actually, I'm wearing a Castle Wars ring, so you could just use that if you want to bank, but it is needed for a clue step. It takes you really close to it, next to the Hobgoblin Island, but I will offer an alternative for that clue scroll. Next is the Xerix Talisman. This is used to do basically every Karend clue scroll, except the Piscorilius one, well, sort of. If you have the Xerix Talisman and the minecart system on Xea, then you could teleport to the raids area, Xerix Honor, and then take the minecart system to Piscorilius and then run to the two clue steps. But if you don't have the minecart system, you're gonna have to teleport to Xerix Heart and run to Piscorilius like that. But if you don't have Xerix Talisman, then for all the clues, you'll just have to take the ship from Potsrim to Great Karend. Now, I believe there's two dig site clue scrolls, and you see that I'm using a dig site pendant, but actually, the better thing to use are the dig site teleport scrolls that you get from clue scrolls. They're like a couple K each, I'm not sure. But they're definitely worth using because they teleport you closer to both of the clues than the dig site pendant. The pendant teleports you slightly north of the dig site, while the scrolls teleport you to the west of it, so it gives you easier access to both clues. It's slightly faster, but it costs a little bit of money, but I think it's worth it. Now, the Kandran headgear acts as a light source for the Lummi Swamp Dungeon clue scroll. It also teleports you close to Sherlock, and Sherlock is close to the Flaxkeeper, which is one of the clue scrolls where you have to speak to him. And then there's the Questscape. Now, the Questscape, that's only used to just get near to a fairy ring, so you could totally just use your POH fairy ring. It's just the Questscape one, it's I'm pretty sure it's the same speed as getting to the POH fairy ring, but it's free, so I just use that. But any way to get to a fairy ring is good, because you do use fairy rings for medium clues. If you don't have fairy rings, I really would just suggest just getting fairy rings, and also if you haven't done Lummi Elite, you'll need a Draymond or Lunar Staff to access the fairy rings. Now, Spade, that's sort of obvious, you need it to dig up the steps where you need to dig stuff. Next is that little, like, grey key you see in my inventory. Now, when I was streaming, a bunch of people were like, what's that key for? And that key, you don't really have to bring it, but it saves you a little bit of time. One of the clues is to go to the desert mining camp, which requires a key from the captain. Now, the captain has, like, 50 or 60 HP, so if you don't bring the key, then you have to kill him every time you get the clue. So, which takes like, well, I don't know, like 10 seconds or something, depending on the weapon you bring. And you do bring a weapon, as you can see. And, but I just brought it because I had inventory space and like, why not? Like, it saves you time in the long run. Like, if you think about it, if you're saving like 10 seconds on each clue over like, let's say 400 medium clues, that's 4,000 seconds if you save 10 seconds on each clue. So, you know, time adds up. Then we've got the Ardy cape. Now, that's an Ardy max cape. So, you just need the Ardy cape that you get from the Easy Diary. Teleports you to the monastery south of Ardoin, and this is for two clues. One clue is you need to kill a monk for a key, and then you teleport somewhere else. Then there's another one where you have to search a crate in the monastery, so it's useful for two clue scrolls. It's also used for a third clue if you don't have a spirit tree in your Playroad house, because only because the spirit tree is slightly faster for that third clue. Then we've got the game's necklace. On this necklace, you use the Berthorpe teleport for like one or two clues. You can also use the Barbarian Outpost teleport on it for multiple clues. But bear in mind, I'm on Luna, so I can use the Barbarian Outpost Teleport, which is slightly better for one of the clues where you need to kill a Barbarian in the Agility Course, and the Barbarian Outpost Teleport on the Luna Spellbook teleports you right next to the Agility Course, opposed to the Barbarian Outpost on the Game Nexus, which teleports you outside the main building. Now, the Ground Seed Pod is a reward from Monkey Madness 2, I think. It's not 100% needed. It's slightly faster than a Spirit Tree in your POH. In one of the clues, we have to go and dig in the Swamp Toad Swamp thing, northwest of the big Grand Tree. So that's why I have it, but if you have a POH Spirit Tree, then that's a little bit slower, but it's faster for like every other gnome clue. Now the next thing is a key. So in medium clue scores, there's some clue scores which ask to, you basically need to get a key for something, then search something, and you can't open that something without the key. So in this clue score, you need to go to the lighthouse to unlock some drawers, but you need a key from a Fremenic Market Guard. So what I did is, when I got the clue scroll, I killed like 28 market guards, so I had 28 keys, but you have to do the drop trick. So if you have any of the keys in the bank or your inventory, the guards won't drop one. So you have to leave them on the floor until you've got 28 or like redrop them so they don't disappear. Now these keys have unique IDs, so the key from the Fremenic guards won't work in any other clue than the lighthouse drawer clue. But the lighthouse drawer clue is the only one where the key isn't sort of like on the way to where you're unlocking, whatever you're unlocking, if you know what I mean. So this is why I only farmed this one key. The rest of them, they're sort of on the way or easy to get to. So that's why I haven't farmed the other keys. But just so you know, as you see by the clues, I have done 400 medium clues and I only use 15 of the keys. So you might not need 28, depending on how many clues you're looking to do. Next up are the runes. So as you can see in my inventory, I have soul runes, air runes, then in my rune pouch, I have lore runes, astral runes, and cosmic runes. Don't need a rune pouch, it's one less withdrawal since you can put 3 runes in it. And I also have a tome of fire and a mud battle staff equipped. This gives you infinite fire runes for the tome of fire, and then infinite water and earth runes from the mud battle staff. So I'm on lunas, and I can switch between lunas obviously for a couple spells, standard spellbook for like all of the normal teleports, and then Arceus for West Ardy teleport, and also Ancients for Lassar teleport, which teleports you to Ice Mountain. If you don't have lunas, or you don't want to use, you should just use lunas. There's no point not to, unless you don't have that. If you don't have lunas, then you're gonna have to just use like Teletubbies or other forms of teleportation. You're gonna have to work that out yourself, but you should mainly be fine with the standard spellbook. You'll just have to run to some places without the teleports, like the Arceus or Ancient teleports. Next is that little necklace you see there, that silver necklace. It's quite new, and it teleports you to 3 places: the Wizard's Tower, the Jorl's Outpost, like the Meeting History and Making History one, and the Desert Eagle Station of the Eagle Transport System in the desert. But for medium clues, you're only going to be using the Wizard Tower one and the Outpost teleport. Now, these are really cheap. They're like 900 GP or something, so I'd really advise getting one, because like there is no quick way to get to the Outpost clue scroll. So that necklace is the best way to get there, so definitely get that. Next is the music cave. Now I understand that not a lot of people will have the music cave, and it's only used for one clue, and this one clue is a dig location clue, which is located west of the guy that the music cave teleports you to. So an easy alternative for that clue is just redirect a house tab to Relica, or have your house at Relica, and then land at the POH portal, then just run south. After that, we've got the rope, and this is for one clue again. Remember the waterfall quest? You need the rope to get across that river to the boulder before you use the rope on the tree. So the clue is located like the first time you use the rope. So after you use the rope on the boulder and then land on the island, that's where the dig location is. You know how I was talking about the clues where you have to kill something for a key and then open something with the key? This is what the whip's for, because sometimes you have to kill like a guard dog which has like 50 HP. So just a whip or a blowpipe or whatever is used to just kill them real quick. And now last, but definitely not least, we have a Tybo One-Eye teleport scroll. Since there are 3 clue scrolls in Tybo One-Eye, the teleport scroll is the easiest way to get there and the fastest way, so you just use the teleport scroll. And this is why it's at the bottom, because if you had it at the top somewhere, and then you used it in a clue on, like, let's say the first step, and then you get an emote clue, it's annoying when the emote items go to the top of your inventory and you can't find them. I just found that annoying. So that's why the scroll and all the usable stuff is at the bottom. So let me just go through the gear really quick. So obviously you've got full graceful, I'm wearing a max cape, and that's useful for getting to your POH. If you don't have a max cape or a construction cape, you're going to want to bring house tabs as well in case you need to get to Canifis. You can just fairy ring it to Canifis, but if you have a portal in your house, then you can use that as well. Other than full graceful, if you don't have full graceful, we'll just wear nothing because you need to be lightweight. But after that, a glory of sorts. I have an eternal glory because like I could, so it's got infinite charges. You don't need an internal glory, you could just have a normal glory, but you have to keep recharging it once it runs out. Then obviously the mud battle staff and tome of fire, have gone through that already, and the jewel ring to get to Alcarid Jewel Arena. Sometimes you need that for the jewelry reading clue. Castle Wars for banking if you don't have a crafting cape. And then Clan Wars, you never use that teleport. Now, the rest of the video is just going to be me doing each clue step. And I didn't record every clue step, but I recorded most of them. Like, I started recording clue steps after my 200th medium clue up until my 400th. So yeah, I definitely recommend that you watch all of these clues now because, much like anything in life, you want to do it correct the first time because then it's hard to break the habit of doing it wrong. So just watch all of the clues, or it's most of them. I might have missed one or two because I just didn't get them in the 200 med clues I started recording. And once you've done like 50 medium clues, you'll just know clues. Like, you'll see a coordinate clue and you'll know where to go without even looking at the map, you know what I mean? So, but yes, I definitely advise watching all these clue scrolls.
We'll be right back. is a healer, but I just can't wait, can't handle the pain. I'm only human, I made a mistake, I promise to change, 'cause I'm hungry.
psychedelic. Psychedelic.
Fingertips on my skin. There's nothing that I wouldn't give to keep this love alive. We gave it all, we gave it up. The chemistry was not enough. do things.